Hi, have you noticed that we have a new device at CSM Studios? You may be wondering what is it for or how to use it. So this is the Behringer X-Touch 1, which is a universal control surface that allows you to operate, in the case of our studios, Logic, Ableton, or Reaper. It also works with Pro Tools, Waveform, Studio One, etc. So basically what this does is instead of using the mouse or the keys on your keyboard, you can operate, for example, the jog wheel and the transport buttons to go forward or backwards and stop play. It also has 34 backlit buttons that allow you to punch in, record, turn on the cycle mode. And one of the coolest features that this has is also when you're doing automation, you can use the touch sensitive and motorized fader. This will allow you to record a smoother movement of the fader instead of using that annoying mouse and kind of like moving the fader up and down, which is kind of annoying. So I'm going to show you how it works and some of the cool features. Let's get right into it. Okay, so let's start with the basics. So we have on the X-Touch, we have the transport buttons, basically stop, play. We can also go move forward or backwards. Now, if you want to record, then you just hit here and that will start recording the track. Also here on this side, you have the scrub, which allows you to kind of like start playing the track. Or move backwards, but while you are playing it, just to locate like quickly a spot on the song in this case. So let's turn it off. We have also, so now we are gonna move up this section on the top, which basically it shows us how to select the track. So for example, if I select the track, then if I move here with the bank or channels, I'm gonna start seeing all the different volumes or levels that the track is at. For example, let's go to the hi-hat. I can mute the track, so let's hit play. I can mute the hi-hat only, or I could solo the hi-hat. Also the recording button that is gonna enable or arm the track basically to have it ready to record. Now, as you can see here, the channel will select whatever channel or track I am at, but I can also use these cursor arrows to go up and down. And as you can see, the fader moves to the position of the volume where the track is at. There's a cool feature of this control surface that allows you to zoom in. So as soon as you turn on this, you can zoom in vertically and horizontally. We can also zoom out again. So that makes it super fast to zoom in and zoom out and go quickly to locate a spot that I need to focus on. Now, moving to this section, we can also jump between markers. Remember when we were using these arrows to kind of like move throughout the song, we can also move between markers. So when I turn on this one, if I press this one, as you can see, it's moving between the markers that I set up before. So I mean, intro, change one and change two. We also can turn on the cycle mode or the loop. So when I hit play, that's only going to loop whatever is there. If I want to set up the length of that loop, I'm gonna keep press this one and then move the jog. And with that, I can just set the range and the length of that loop or cycle. I also have the feature of auto punch. So when I turn on this one, it's gonna be ready to auto punch and record whenever I'm ready. I can also replace a recording that I was doing. I can turn on the click or metronome. And I can also work in solo mode. So for this solo mode is different than this one. So for this one is the solo to solo the track. In this case, for example, the piano. is the one that is solo right now. But let's say that I want to select specific audio regions, I can select those and then solo them globally. So let's say, for example, I want to select this, and this track. As soon as I select them, then I can press the solo mode, and as you can see, only those tracks are selected, and those are only the ones that are going to be played. So for example, if I move here quickly to this area, only those three are playing. So that's also a good, cool feature. Finally, one of them, I guess that this is the most important feature of this control surface, and you kind of like already have seen it, because when I've been playing the tracks, the faders have been going up and down. So I'm going to show you that. So that's the automation mode. So as you can see, I was doing something here. So let's go and select a different track. So let's turn off this. Let's do automation on the sitar. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to change this to touch, and I'm going to do some automation on that track specifically. I hit play. As soon as I move the fader, it's going to do the changes on the sitar. So let me maybe just solo this guy. Now with the touch mode, the thing is that whenever you release the fader, it's going to go back to its original mode. As soon as I release the fader, it will go back to zero. Now in latch mode, the difference is that whatever I leave the fader at, that's where it's going to stay. So if I hit play, for example, if I move the fader with the latch, the fader is going to be there if I release it there. It's not going to go back to its original position as with the touch. So those are kind of like the two most important modes. Of course, there's the ride mode, which will basically erase everything that I've done. If I start riding, you see that now it's going back. I'm not moving anything on the fader, but it's kind of going back to zero. That's the ride mode. Just to now maybe like kind of like undo what you were doing. There's also the trim mode, which is gonna just do some little changes in volume. Just tiny changes. Now, if I hit play, you will see all the different changes that I've done in the track. Now, as you can see, also something that is worth pointing out is that this control surface also gives you signal. It has a little meter that shows the level of the signal. So right now it's quite low. So yeah, that was basically it. So as you can see, this control surface is very, very simple to use, very intuitive, and the more you use it, the faster you're gonna get used to it. All right, so I hope that the video helped you to get more familiar with the X-Touch One, and you can start implementing it in your future projects at CSM Recording Studios. Thanks for watching.